Gillian Bell is in the house. Gillian is the organizer of this whole amazing day. Such an honor to be in space with all of you. So if you want, you could put your name in the chat and claim your seat. So I was just talking about Mother's Day being a space that's not always filled with sweetness and light and flowers and goodness. It can be challenging for some of us. It can be hard, and not just for the people who have maybe disconnected relationships with their mothers, but also for the women who have lost their children. And my shirt says, my sisters are warriors. And this shirt was bought by from an indigenous tribe called Thrive, where they, all of the proceeds of the shirts that you buy go to women who are in tribes in where they are not treated well and they are beaten. And so I raise up all of those women who are in relationships that don't feel safe. I raise this up to also my personal sister who lost her one and only child this year. And I raise it up to anyone who is also suffering. And I want to also make this light, right? So this is about Mother Earth, who is suffering, right? But we have and are in a position where we can take care of Mother Earth, and we can take care of, as nurturers, the people that might be suffering. And whether that's through our words, or that's through our pockets, or that's through digging our hands in the soil to nurture where we live. So I'm coming in from the unceded territory of the Lenape Munsee tribe and upstate New York in Sullivan County. I am surrounded by water, fire, a little bit of earth, my baby plants, and lots of air. I can hear all the birds chirping. It's the most glorious thing. And so this practice today is going to incorporate all of those elements, the four elements. We're going to get up, we're going to move. But at first, I want to just claim our seats. And so with you sitting in a comfortable seat with your spine tall, I'm wearing red in honor of the Indigenous women who are often forgotten. That was what was asked of me, and I thought, this is the greatest sweatshirt I could wear. So find your seat. If it feels comfortable for you, close your eyes. And connect down to Mother Earth. Allow your seat to ground. As you rise up to Father Heaven, the skies, the mystery abound. In front of us are those leaders, those mothers, our ancestors, who teach and nurture us. And behind us are the young ones that look up to us, that see us in a light that sometimes we are not sure and not prepared to be in, right? But claim your seat, because to the right and to the left of you is this circle. The sacred circle was opened by Joan Allison Henry this morning in a beautiful ceremony that called in all of the directions. It was a stunning 7:30 a.m. call, and I'm carrying it on. The Zoom space has allowed us to do some magic, and I'm carrying on calling in the directions, the ancestry, and anyone else you wish to call in. I call in my sister, so you can place your hand on your heart and call into the circle anyone who might be suffering today, who's lost a child or is in not a safe relationship. Call them into the circle. And when you practice today, when we move, you're moving for that person or that group of people. When you sit in silence, you're sitting in silence with and for those people. And so join me in a moment as I ring this bell to call in the circle and all of the beings that we've called in. And perhaps it's a ancestor, not well ancestor, that you want to call in. Don't worry, we'll call in the well ones. And take a moment. And so we'll begin with air, our life force. And so what I want you to do is take your right pointer finger and place it over your right nostril. So we're gonna breathe in and out of the left nostril. If you need a moment to like breathe in both your nostrils and like shake it around, maybe you got some stuff in there that you want. And then we're gonna exhale out everything and slowly start breathing in. We're gonna begin the circle and end the circle with the breath, air. And just begin slowly inhaling and exhaling through that left nostril. See if in breathing through the left nostril, you can lengthen the breath, you can let your belly soften. You can let maybe your shoulders soften. Keep going for just a few more moments, a few more breaths. Once you've completed the last exhale, release your right nostril. We're going to begin to move nice and slowly. Now we're moving into water. So you're moving your wrists around and just waking up your wrists. Circle your wrists. Yeah. And then start to move it into your arms, perhaps your shoulders. Do a little backstroke. Now, if you are not yet on a mat or on the floor, you can actually do this in a seat if you want. I'm gonna move myself over to my mat. So keep moving your shoulders. And if you want, then you can move in your neck. So perhaps move your neck side to side. I don't love circling the neck, but if that feels good to you, you can circle halfway on the bottom and then look up to the skies and circle halfway in the back. Finding the movement, continuing with the arms and letting now the torso move in. So letting your shoulders, your rib cage, maybe the breath comes in a little bit more. You're free to move in the element, with the element of water as you desire. So whatever is calling for you, you can even come onto your hands and your knees and perhaps circle around. If that feels good, if it doesn't feel good on your wrists, you can come onto your fists and find some length in the back of your wrists. Beautiful. And now go ahead and lift a knee and circle a knee, the hip. Get into your legs. Circle it all the way around and then lift your foot in the air behind you and get that ankle, right? We forget about our ankles and our toes often. So give some love and circle around in your ankle. And keep the breath swirling. Coming back onto the other side now. Circle the other knee. All the way around. Get into the ankles. Maybe the toes need some love. Beautiful. And then go ahead and bring yourself into a position. We're going to link the air and the water. So inhale, look up into your cow, and then exhale, come all the way down into child's pose. And then ripple back up as you look up, inhaling and exhaling. And just find the fluidity in the movement, moving along with the breath, allowing yourself to connect the water, the freedom into the air space. Take a few more breaths just like this. Beautiful. And then we're just gonna come into a downward facing dog if that feels comfortable to you. And then go ahead and find the fluidity as you wish. This might be your first downward facing dog, so move as you wish. Bend one knee.
Circle yourself forward. And then walk your feet forward. Let yourself hang. And then roll up one vertebrae at a time, all the way to stand.
So when you stand, we're gonna try connecting all four of the elements together, okay? So you're inhaling the arms up, exhaling for air, exhaling down into a seat for a little fire. We'll move into fire next. Forward fold over like a waterfall. And then grounding down in your feet, let yourself exalt up towards the sky into grounding down into earth, inhaling air, exhaling fire. Let the waterfall come down as you forward fold. And then roll up one vertebrae at a time into the earth. Inhaling up. Air, sitting down, fire. Let the water fall and ground up. You know what to do now. Just move like this on your own. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. One more time. Beautiful. And then bring your hands to prayer before your heart. So we've had a year. I'm going to come back down to you. We've had a year where a lot of us have felt in our adrenal system quite a bit of fatigue because we've been in fight, flight, or freeze. And so we're bringing on the fire now. And as we bring on the fire, we are moving our body. I learned this from a practice I've started studying, which is Koya. When a gazelle goes to the watering hole, the gazelle is in rest and digest. And then the lion comes. And what we all have inside of us is that adrenaline that allows us to flee, fight, or freeze. We've been in a lot of freeze, flight, or freeze this year, right? And so they move, and the weakest or the slowest gets killed. But what do the gazelle do after that? They don't walk around and go, oh my God, did you see what happened? Oh my God. They shake their bodies. They shake their bodies so much. They shake their bodies so much that they then are able to go and rest and digest. So, my loves, let's just start. I'm going to give you a little music with this. Here we go. Now, start by simply shaking your hand, your right hand, where you are. Just shake your hand. Just shake that one hand forward, back. Give it some movement, right? And then simply let it rest. And just take note of what's happened in between the right and the left hand.
Wake up, everybody. Sleeping in bed.
Let's do this.
No more.
Keep going now in that right hand. You've got the notice. You know what's going to happen to your body now. Let it shake. Go with your right. And shaking the shoulder.
Shake it up. And move into your left hand now. And give it some love. You can keep that right hand going. And get into the shoulders. And shake your shoulders. Shake your shoulders. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Tina shakes it. Pop up the shoulders, up and down like Tina. Go ahead, shake it. Now get into your belly and your hips. How does that feel? Is it something you do all the time? And start to shake the legs. Shake out the legs. And if you want, you can come onto your backs and shake your legs. And let it jiggle. Shake it up. Let your feet go. Let your legs go. Push yourself all the way to that edge. Let yourself complete. Time to build a new so when you're ready, come back up. I know we could do it. Shake your whole body. The hips. Only thing we have to do is put it in our minds. Shake it, shake it, shake it. Work shake your head. We'll do it every time. Give it 30 more seconds of really getting in there. Letting your body shake. Let yourself lose your breath. Think of a fire flickering, a bonfire with a bunch of us around it, right? Imagine. Good. 10 more seconds. And then be still. And try and truly be still. Maybe there's some tingling. What it used to be. The breath is finding its place in the heartbeat. The heartbeat, the center of us. It's moving a little bit faster. Take your arms up. We're coming back through this practice with adding all of the elements coming down into fire, sitting forward fully. And then roll up. Inhaling. Exhaling, coming into all of the elements. Forward fully. Roll up. One more time. I'm talking about don't push up. Stop pushing. Don't use up. Stop using the don't. Wake up. Beautiful. Yeah. And now, ladies, let's take ourselves onto our mat and find a nice wide stance. I'm going to tilt my screen up just a bit. So, toes out, sit. You preach up. You can get with the element of fire, right? Pushing us forward. So we can have a forest fire, right? Blazing bonfire. You can also have the flicker of a candle. Go ahead and take your right arm on top of your left. And crisscross your arms. And go ahead and lift. The elbow down. And just sit your feet forward. Breathe into your belly. Breathe into the back of your heart. Sit your seat a little bit lower. And just a little bit lower. Yeah.
warriors.
Help me, you businessman. What?
Now, if you need, you can add a little bit of water in. Maybe your body is feeling a little bit stagnant, and you want to just like adjust yourself into this posture, but then move right in
to the warrior and stay again in that same steady
breath. Go a little deeper.
We need each other.
And find that slow, like candle burn. Try not to move too much now. For three breaths and bend your belly a little bit more.
Everybody, we need. No more sleeping in bed. No more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. Wake up all your teachers.
Go ahead and inhale the arms up and bring the hands to your hips and bring your toes forward and adjust yourself into that same dance. Right? Move your hips around. This time, arms out, left arm in top and twist it around. Lift your elbows high and dig your seat a little bit further to the earth. Sit a little bit deeper to the earth. Maybe a little bit deeper. Feeling yourself shake. That's good. Don't push too hard, but feel the burn. And then go ahead and lift yourself up. We are all warriors. My sisters are warriors. And I have three bio sisters, but I have hundreds, thousands of sisters. Anyone I come in circle with is my sister. If you are my sister, bend your front knee a little bit more. And let's get into that element of fire. What does that mean to you? Is fire raging? Or is fire subtle? What about the element of the morning? A different compound of, One more breath here, a little bit deeper.
Pick me up each time I fail.
Come back to Grandma's center.
Boy, they really came.
Bring your arms up. And then go ahead and sink one more time. And this time, take your arms out to an L shape. Goddess.
Grandma's
rise. And a little bit more and rise and go ahead and sink. And then going back into that fire, take your hands and bring some vocals to it. Ha, 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 ha. Shake off what you no longer need. Shake it off. Let it go wild in the hands. Let it go. This song is resilience, right? We've built a whole new language around resilience. And as mamas, I've taken on a huge amount of what our kids are learning and what our parents are learning, what our communities are learning. Ha, 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 ha. Let it go. Beautiful. And then go ahead and really let it go. Arms come up. And bring your hands to prayer before your heart. You can bring your hands to your sides if you wish. And just see. Hold on.
Realigned and on point. Power to the peaceful. Prayers to the waters, women at the center, all vessels open to give and receive.
system right down to its knees.
Let's see the system right down to its knees. Three more of our arms up, coming down, bring all four of the elements together, sending it to the fire. Letting the water flow and rising up through Mother Earth, Pachamama, inhale. Three times, you know what to do. Let the water flow. Lift your heart and let forward.
really dig in to listen to what your body needs today. What's it calling for? It might not look like what my shape looks like. Honor you, Mama. Come back onto your hands and your knees. And circle around. Anything that feels good now. Embody the three elements. You can bring in air too if you wish. The breath, I suppose that's always lingering underneath it all. And make your way back into a seated position. We're going to do perhaps the seated position looks like you laying on the ground, or Virginia, you holding your baby. Perhaps you feel like you want to lie on the ground, and that's great too. Take yourself into whatever position you want. I'm going to move you through a guided meditation. So bring yourself to that air source. The breath. And just notice, just take a scan right now of what's going on in your body. What's going on in the breath? And then bring yourself to that space right at your root, the pelvic floor, right at the bottom of your spinal cord. This space allows us to feel at home. Grounded, rooted. Breathe into that space. Give that space all of the space that it needs to begin to start rooting down. The next space, right on top of it, for those of us who have a womb, who've carried, and every single one of us have been carried in this space. So the first element is earth. The second element here is water, where we came from. Our first truths in life was darkness. Our first truth was water. First element was water. This is the source of our creativity, our sensuality, our ability to savor. Breathe into that space. Imagine for a moment some flowers being dripped dropped and thrown into that pelvic bowl to heal. Next, find your solar plexus right by the rib cage. This is our fire, our ability to go out there and do something and make change. This gives us our will. This gives us our fire. Moving up into the heart. Where all things flourish, our passions, where we understand and learn compassion. And sometimes it breaks, but it's never completely broken. Because we come back down through the earth into our creativity and our will to then move into, oh, that's right, passion, compassion, understanding. In the center of our throat, is where we source the truth and speak it. We say it loudly. We call out injustices. We build up that ability by understanding the truth. Sometimes we need data. But then we get the truth and then we know and we use our voices. We advocate for ourselves, we advocate for our children, we advocate for our community. We advocate for all the children. And we speak up. And if we don't have that ability, find someone who does. Align yourself with that person. And you too will find that voice. The space above that is our intuition, our deep knowing. It's also the centers of our adrenal system. So we shook our bodies like we shook our bodies before to release in the pituitary. And the adrenal system that has been overloaded with fear this year, uncertainty. The shaking allows us to move back into rest and digest so we can process the next. And then about the crown of your head. Is where we connect to source. That could be a higher power. That can be honestly the air. Whatever you wish. See if you can make space there right now. About a foot above your head is the soul's calling, the Ba. Space we don't often talk about. I'm asking you to call upon that space now. Our highest of high. Ourselves. And from this space, imagine around you a glowing light about 2 feet around you, surrounding you, protecting you, holding you, guiding you. Bring yourself back to the center of your heart. And you can call upon right now the well ones, the ancestors that you looked up to, or the mamas, or the leaders in your community, the friends that you admire. I Let's make that group bigger than the ones that needed us today. Let's bring our allies together in this circle, the ones that show us how to nurture not just maybe our children, but ourselves and our mamas. Those that teach us how to be the well ones in our communities. When there is something not well, they find solution. They nurture. They fix. They work hard. They use source. They ask for help. Bring those people in. The ones that understand that the community is not just those around you. The community is your entire town or city. The community is the state. And even bigger, it's this earth. Call upon those people that are looking and tending to the earth. And those that aren't well, and those that don't know how to ask for help or can't get it. Those looking to root out all of the systems that are no longer serving us. And by the roots, I mean digging deep and shaking shit up. Who are those people? Let's call them into the circle. So, take a deep breath in, let it go. So we're in a nice rested state. I call for you in these last 2 minutes to remain there, or I'm gonna do something fun because I wanna dance. I wanna bring out the reverie. So if you are called to, this is one of our family's favorites. Get up and just move your body as you wish. I'm gonna put the volume up. Can you guys all hear it? Yeah? All right.
Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Yeah. Hey, Every day can be a better day despite the challenge. All you gotta do is leave it better than you found it. It's gonna get difficult to stand, but hold your balance. I just say whatever, cause there is no way you're round it. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay, it's okay. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in Doku, walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Some days you wake up and nothing works, you feel surrounded. Gotta give your feet some gravity to get you grounded. Keep the things inside your ears just like the waves and sound it. And just say whatever, cause there is no way you're grounded. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay, it's okay. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in Doku, walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey, feeling good, like I should. When in Doku, walk around the neighborhood.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I love you, people. Bye, y'all. Thank you so much. Oh, thank you, Lucas, for saying the song's name. Beautiful. Thank you all. Mwah, mwah, mwah. So much love. Have a beautiful day. Hi, Leslie. Hi, Rebecca in Mexico. My gosh. So happy to have you guys here. I think the next class is starting.